Let's go finish this off.
There's like a 6 or 7 year old Jalen on a high school field, like trying to hop in the drills. Is that right?
Yeah, the summer conditioning programs, the little quarterback drills, running back drills, receiver drills, all of it. You know, I just wanted to play ball. Mm-hmm.
I think that's something that not everyone knows about you, that your connection to this game runs deep.
Runs very deep.
When do you think you fell in love with it?
Man, my dad always tells a story. You know, my brother grew up, you look at old pictures. My brother grew up, he had a basketball in his hand, like as a child, like 2, 3 years old. Mm-hmm. For whatever reason, I had a football in mind, you know, and, you know, it's always been in me, you know, and just my childhood, the way I was raised and what I've gone through, it's something that I love and I give my all towards.
Well, you can tell everybody, yeah, you can tell everybody, go ahead and tell everybody.
There's no point where you'll arrive. It's only the journey.
January 8th comes in to take over for the guy that won that game. Jalen getting some pressure down the middle. He throws a strike to Irv Smith for the first down. Just inside the 16, quarterback draw, Jalen Hurts! Touchdown!
Been through the words, but I still get my pain. God made my
incomplete, and Alabama has won it!
And he's getting the ball a lot here early.
Look in his direction on first down, Jalen Hurts on target, missed, tucked on, and he goes away! The Hurts ball up against the line quickly. Left, lofting left, going for the end zone, and it is caught for the touchdown.
Dude, Montez, I'm turning to something here. I think this young quarterback is finding his groove. Him and his play caller, Nick Sirianni. I'll tell you what.
You can tell everybody. Go ahead and tell everybody.
Going deep. And caught by Devontae Smith for the touchdown. And he just put away for the Eagles. Touchdown.
Yeah, I mean, you see it just about every Sunday. You see him making a play out of the pocket or extending a play with his legs and making a big throw with his arm. You know, he's definitely someone that's really difficult to defend. I'm glad he's on our team, that's for sure.
What we strive for and how we're able to overcome. So I'm very happy about that today.
You guys are a winning team now for the first time, and I think you're qualified for the playoffs if it ended today.
I'm gonna cut you off.
What does that mean?
I'm gonna cut you off. I'm not in the business of talking about anything but being in the moment.
You can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody.
Go ahead and tell everybody.
say one thing. How the week that we put together, that's what showed up out there. We worked off. So man, let's do that each and every day, man. Don't take no moment for granted. You know what I'm saying? Cause that right there, that's what we showed up all week. All week, it showed up out there, man. So don't get it twisted. It's on us. It's on us. And it's how we prepare each and every week. Go ahead, Jay.
Exact same thing he just said. We prepared our best and we played our best. When our best was needed. Now, I don't put no limits to this. Continue to grow and continue to lay everything on the line right now. Lay everything on the line. These once in a lifetime opportunities we got right in front of us in our hand. So what the you gonna do? What you gonna do? The talent that we gotta have, man, it don't have to be none different than what we done practiced all month. Yeah, let's work your ass off every day. Let's stay together. We're a family. We unite together and we gonna dog together. That's what we gonna do. That's what we is. So enjoy this, huh? Enjoy this. You understand?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. I know the job isn't done.